inside my head. Hands up if you're down to get down tonight. 'Cause it's always a good time. Slept in all my clothes like I didn't care. Hopped into a cab, take me anywhere. I'm in if you're down to get down tonight. 'Cause it's always a good time. Good morning and good night. I wake up at twilight. It's gonna be alright. We don't even have to try. It's always a good time. Let's hang out if you're down to get down tonight. 'Cause it's always a good time. Good morning and good night. I wake up at twilight. It's gonna be alright. We don't even have to try. It's always a good time. Be alright, 'cause we don't even have to try. It's always a good time. Whoa, oh, whoa, it's always a good time. Whoa, we don't even have to try. It's always a good time. Yeah, yeah, good time. Whoa, it's always a good time.
Dropped off tonight and getting out of the limos and other cars and vehicles. You know, I noticed obviously how wonderful you look and how beautiful the ladies look and how stunning the gentlemen look. But what I couldn't stop thinking about was what a remarkable group of young people you are and how proud I am of you people and how I kept thinking as I shook hands and was talking to people about how I'm going to see so many of you later in life when you have your careers and own your businesses and stuff. And I look forward to that. Because I have a lot of respect and pride. So congratulations to the grads. There are not too many evenings in our lives where we get to celebrate something important. And tonight is one of those, and tonight is solely about you. We are honoring you, we want you to have fun, we want you to eat a lot, dance a lot, enjoy the time with your friends. Because you worked hard in your school years, you're going on to bigger and better things, and we want to wish you the very best. So congratulations, grads of 2000.
Mr. Palmer and I will both be retiring this year, and we appreciate being up here to address our very last grad class, the grad class of 2013. We are also graduating to a new phase in our lives, much like you are. Mr. Palmer has been teaching at GP for 37 years. He arrived in 1979. He went right to UBC to be a PE teacher and graduated in 1975. I've been teaching at GP for 19 years. I arrived in 1993. I didn't start UBC till much later and graduated in 1982. We were both born in 1953. We both graduated from our high schools in 1971. Who would know our paths would cross so many years later? We both chose teaching careers and ended up at Guildford Park. We both saw major changes happen at GP. before our time, there was a name change from Mary Jean Shannon School to Guildford Community to Guildford Junior, and finally, Guildford Park Secondary. In 1993, the building went through a demolition, renovation, and addition of B Wing, the plaza, gym, and library. The school even had an address change from 107 Avenue to 146th Street. The population has steadily rose from 800 to over 1,250 students. What hasn't changed is the blending of cultures. It is the students who make up the school. Guildford's unique population of over 56 different home languages has made our school a great place to be in. It makes us a multicultural melting pot and has become a place where everyone matters.
Guild Park students, you can be proud of the many achievements during your high school years. You have reached many personal goals, both in academics and electives and in sports. Some of you have won scholarships, others have received trophies, and I speak on behalf of all the staff that we are very proud of your successes. But as important as all these individual awards are, as teachers, we would like all of you to learn what it's like to be a volunteer, and that the person who gives back to people who have made a difference and a positive influence on your life is very important for your future. Students in this room have learned the benefits of volunteering and giving back. This passion to give back will always be with you. Once you've tried it, it makes a difference in your lives as well as the lives of your friends, your parents, and co-workers. Many students have volunteered at Guild Park this year as referees, as scorekeepers, as peer tutors, as club leaders, poster maker, student council, and grad council. Members of dances that are organizing dances, it's a very long list. One special event this year was on Valentine's Day when students and staffs were greeted with a note taped to every locker in the school and on the doors of the school. And on these notes were written words of kindness. And I noticed a lot of students coming in early that morning and the surprise they had to see a little note addressed to them and their lockers. It was a wonderful idea, and it couldn't have happened without volunteers doing all that work after school. These volunteers had a positive impact on every student and teacher in the building. Another special moment this year was that very large blue tarp that covered the entire science wing and the art wing, and the big white letters of Grad 2013. Awesome idea, it was outstanding, very positive. There are so many other ways of giving back, and some of you have been doing this all year. You've been stopping to help people pick up books that they've dropped. You've helped coaches with equipment. You've helped teachers cleaning up their classrooms. Even something as simple as showing up early to a meeting, getting fees paid on time, that is a form of giving back to the person that organizes those events. I'd like to know how many athletes in here took the time to thank scorekeepers after the game. If those students did not volunteer to help keep score at those games, you would not have games after school. Think about this as you leave Guildford Park. Your future may change because of this. Giving others your time brings in you interesting and challenging opportunities that might not come along if you did not volunteer. This experience can be added to your resume and could result in a more rewarding job in the future. Many volunteers experience a sense of increased self-esteem and a greater sense of worth. Helping others makes you feel good about yourself. And you can start here tonight with a simple thank you, and you've already done that. I was impressed with you grads standing up and applauding all the work that the volunteers did tonight. So that culture of giving back is alive and well in this room. And I strongly encourage you that when you start your new jobs, or you meet a new group of people at university, that when given a chance to volunteer and to make a difference in people's lives, that you step forward. It will be the most important thing that you do in your future, and it will open a lot of doors for you.
We wish all our Guildford Park students the best success in work, furthering your education and relationships. May all your friendships evolved through high school remain with you all your lives.
We wish all our staff, especially the new and young staff, the best success and hope you remain at Guildford Park for maybe 19 or 37 years. The rest of the night is yours to enjoy the dinner, the desserts, the dancing, the dry bread, and fun.
Enjoying the hotel? Is everybody hungry? I know we are. And we are happy to announce that dinner is finally ready.
Yeah.
Just kidding. You have to wait till we're done.
Please bear with us as we take time to thank our wonderful staff of Guildford Park. Now everyone, close your eyes and think back to the end of grade 7. You're being prepared for high school, and you're filled with mixed emotions. You were excited to go someplace new, make new friends, and scared to try new things.
I personally remember my elementary teacher always telling our class how hard our high school would be. And you know what? High school was a breeze.
Good, it was easy.
Yes, Annie, thank you. But in all seriousness, I remember coming to high school in grade 8, and I was actually pretty scared of the older grades, and how the school was so much bigger than our elementary school. However, our teachers were very nice to us, and made us feel welcome and loved. During the first week of high school, we would jam up the hallways, get pushed around, and everybody hated us, except our teachers. They always lent us a shoulder to cry on. With support of our teachers and experience, within 3 weeks, we already knew our way around the school. They've become our friends.
For a lot of international students going to high school in a different country, can be difficult and terrifying, especially if you're not fluent in its language. Going to high school from an elementary school can be quite scary, but going to high school from a different country is even scarier. I didn't know anybody when I first came here, and I could barely speak English. However, thanks to teachers and their support, attending school in a foreign country was a lot less stressful for a number of students, including me.
Teachers are always there for us, whether we need help on homework that is due the next day, or help regarding personal dilemmas. Their wisdom helped us a numerous number of times in dealing with problems starting from homework to helping us realize what we want to accomplish in the future. They also help set up our goals and decide which post-secondary we want to go to. When our parents couldn't be there for us for certain reasons, teachers were one of the adults we could always ask for help. They always want the best for us, and they inspired us to challenge ourselves and become better.
We cannot thank you enough for countless afternoons and evenings you spent in school helping us organize and set up for various events. Thank you for giving up your Thursday evenings to help supervise our school dances. If it wasn't for you, a lot of us wouldn't have had the last slow dance with the person we like. Also, we are very grateful to you for moving our Friday test to Monday whenever the whole class wasn't ready, thus giving us extra 2 days to study for our tests. It helped a lot. Also, we really appreciate you getting up at 6 in the morning to help out with the pancake breakfast. Thanks to everyone who came out to help and serve food. It was great.
And since our teachers made us feel welcome and loved during our first few weeks, we returned the favor to the new teachers who came to Guildford Park and made them feel welcome. We learned from you guys and actually made good use of it. Are you guys proud of us? Oh yeah, okay. Also, thank you for going that extra mile every day to make sure that we understand what you're talking about. The grade 12 year can be pretty stressful considering all the exams and finals we have to do. But thanks to your efforts, your help, and your study tips, you saved us from a lot of stress. Also to our teachers who help out as coaches after school. The time you put into all these extracurricular activities are not gone unnoticed. Also our counselors, who are always so kind and do not hesitate to help us. In fact, they practically counsel us.
And can we please get a shout out to all the teachers for spending countless hours photocopying different booklets and worksheets for us. Do you realize how long it takes to ensure the correct alignment of the paper and also to make sure that both sides of the paper are used? And don't forget the time it takes to sort all of them into separate booklets and to staple them. And a big thank you to janitors for not getting mad at us and letting us stay really late in school.
Does everyone remember their first job?
Yep.
Okay. Remember struggling to find three references during Planning 10? Who was there for you when you only had two? Our teachers, of course. They were always there for us if we needed them. They filled our empty void of references. You guys are awesome. Oh, yeah. Our teachers always told us that high school would fly by. And honestly, I didn't believe that until now. I'd always look forward and say, oh, there's three more years left, two more years left. But now school's over. It's a bittersweet victory, reaching the end of this road. Great memories and experiences were shared with our teachers.
Did we mention that we'd like to thank our teachers for making us feel welcome and loved? Thanks for making us feel welcomed and loved.
I feel welcome and loved. And at this time, we'd like to invite two very special teachers tonight. In fact, they're very special.
They're dear and near to our hearts. Please give a warm welcome to Mr. Palmer and Ms. Morgan.
Mr. Chambers' final year at Guildford Park. Yeah, so he'll be meeting at Guildford Park next season. And we kind of honored him at the athletic banquet. But this is our really fair, our true farewell, because then we just make fun of him. But now we really have words that really explain how we really feel about this great man. So first up is Damien.
Mr. Chambers, words cannot describe my appreciation and gratitude for you. This is by far one of my favorite volleyball seasons. Thank you for training me to be an awesome libero. Kelowna was an unforgettable experience, especially the hash browns.
Mr. Chambers, these 4 years at GP could have never been better. Without you there, thank you for being a great coach and a GP, and thank you for your guidance and support. We will miss you and hope your new school welcomes you with open arms.
My words cannot describe Mr. Chambers and his personality, and I would like to thank him for all his support throughout the year and especially in volleyball season. I will never forget his speeches about resilience. Thanks, Mr. Chambers, for being an awesome coach and vice principal. Wish you good luck.
Good evening. Sorry in advance if you understand my English, because I'm not a bad thing. So just bear along with me. A few days ago, Ms. Nielsen asked me to send her what I'm going to talk about today. But I only sent her the second part, because the first part is about her. Ms. Nielsen, you are the most caring teacher that I know. Everybody here knows how hard you work and how busy you are with all the school events. Along with all that, I would like to thank for what you have done for our volleyball team. You are our biggest fan, biggest supporter. Thank you for driving us to all the games. And trust me, they are much safer driver than Mr. Chamber. Also, thank you for cheering for us and all the food after the game. That's very sweet from you. So, thank you. Okay. Back to Mr. Chamber. Volleyball is the highlight of my grade 12 year. You are truly the best. We're so lucky to have you. You are amazing, awesome. You taught me a lot. You taught me that you might not be the best at what you do, but you should be the one who offer the most, the work. Like what he always said, you should go out there, give your 110% of your capability. Just give your best and enjoy the moment. When you know you give your best, win or lose, doesn't matter, no longer matter anymore. He also taught me resilient, always get back up, no matter what beat you down. People often say they will forget someone or something, but I know for sure that I will never forget you and also this guy here. You guys are amazing. I could not ask for a better team. So, thank you.
Being this my first year in volleyball, I couldn't have asked for a better coach than you. You made me see the sport in a different way, and I honestly think I like volleyball more than basketball now.
Get off the stage.
I've never met a person like you who goes beyond being a coach and rather a friend. I want to thank you for everything you've done for this team. I'll never forgive you. I love you, dude.
Forgive you.
Being our coach for the last 2 years. At first I thought you were a pretty awkward guy. I still think you kind of are. But you're a pretty cool dude. I love how you and Ms. Nielsen always take us volleyball athletes to McDonald's. The happiest place on earth. Right after a game. I'll for sure never forget you and your amazing driving skills. Even ask Ms. Nielsen. But anyways, it was a good two years. I wish you good luck in the future.
Thank you. So, Ong is not here because he's graduating next year, so I'm going to be speaking on his behalf. So, Mr. Chambers, I literally copied and pasted this off of Ong's Facebook message, so you know how his English is, so bear with me. Tell him I said, keep it, and ask him if he's going to miss me, and if he says yes, then be like, don't worry about it.
Tony's in grade 11, the only person on our team, so this is what he said. I would like to thank Mr. Chambers for his last 2 years of coaching me on the senior boys volleyball team. I was surprised when I passed tryouts for the team as a junior. Mr. Chambers has given me the opportunity to learn different techniques to approaching a problem and solving it. For example, resilience. Even when our team was down and performing horribly, we got the speech of getting our mind set into the game and the fear of our punishments for losing. Again, thank you, Mr. Chambers, for helping with the boys' volleyball team.
All right, so this is what I have to say. Dear Mr. Sean Chambers, words cannot express my gratitude for you. You have listened to me for countless hours, and whenever I thought there was no path ahead, you showed there was. Your insight has shown me that no matter how dark life can become, if you look hard enough, you'll see a small lantern fighting to be seen. And with your help, that small lantern has become a blazing inferno, and it will stay that way for the rest of my life. On the court, you put your faith in me to deliver perfect results on a consistent basis, and because of this pressure, I learned not to be afraid of adversity, but to embrace it and then conquer it. I can only hope that in the future, I can affect someone's life as you have affected mine. Now, onto the magic word, resilience. Who would have thought that one word would play such a vital part in my life? You have taught me something that is not found in any textbook, and for that matter, not found in any curriculum except yours. You showed us that when you are at the lowest of your lows, that is where you discover the most powerful trait life has to offer. A trait that can turn losers into winners, failure into success, and most importantly, 12 individuals into a family over the countless hours of you preaching it. It is unbelievable how well you understand the human nature and can provoke greatness out of anyone, only if you can apply that concept to yourself. If I am lucky enough to acquire any type of success, it is unequivocally all because of you. It is unfortunate that Guildford Park is losing you. However, I am glad for Fleetwood Park. They have gained a caring vice principal who connects with his students, always has his door open, an excellent coach who goes beyond what is required of him and not only improves your skills, but also improves you as a human being. And at the end of the day, a kind, caring, inspiring, generous, and warm-hearted individual who thrives to help everyone. Thank you for being you, and please for the love of all that is holy and righteous, don't ever, ever change.
For everything that you've done for me, both as a coach and a person. Through everything you have done, you have basically become a father to this team. You've taught us, inspired us, drove us, and even fed us. But for the future, to stick to fast food. Getting to know you was a great experience that I certainly will never forget. Our 1,000 pep talks before and after the game will always be memorable. You've inspired me in endless ways.
There was no way, this is just coincidence, that she's reading that book at some random Starbucks when you read the book at the time of Da Vinci. Doesn't make sense. Mr. Chambers, I don't care what that referee from Tumanula says. You are a classy man and an exceptional one at that. You're the person I look up to, metaphorically. You've taught me unforgettable lessons which have molded me into who I am today. Dedication, resilience, how life is just a game of inches and getting the most out of a dollar. Those are just some of the lessons that you've taught me, and now we're just scratching the surface. And now I'm feeling sad. Now, when I'm feeling sad or stressed, I'll take your advice and just watch the music video of Kung Fu Fighting. I'm glad that I can call you not just my vice principal, reference, or coach, but also my friend. I'm sad to see you leave, and Guildford Park is losing a great man. But sometimes, things need to fall apart and make way for better things. And now, in September, we'll be off, individually wandering the halls of life, lost. But getting lost is not always fatal. Almost every time, it'll make your world better.
without further ado, we're calling on Mr. Chambers.
So this is a classic gift for a coach, but he's a classy man. And the next gift is my personal favorite. Not gonna lie, I came up with the idea.
It's a little naughty.
So in here is a copy of the speech, which I'm sure you'll frame up and put it on your fridge, because it's just that great. You should be, and I'll ask you to open this up. First, take a look at it. Well, actually, no, they'll see. Enjoy.
I don't even have to see this. It cannot be shown. Needless to say, I am speechless. I will just say really quick that my 4 years here at Guildford Park have been absolutely incredible, and I think that the only thing that I wish is I had one more year to kind of finish off an entire 5 years with a starting grade 8 class, but I gotta tell you, these guys here are an absolutely classy group. I have enjoyed working with all of you. I know I started with you guys when you guys were in grade 9, but I wish every one of you guys the very best of luck. I want to thank these guys for a wonderful speech there. And I know that I am now in the way between you and dinner, so I am going to sit down. But thank you guys very much. Appreciate it.
Once I finish reading these to you, see, you did not follow instructions well first time. Let's see how you do this time. All right, I read this to you for a few. Then I show you videos some kids made. I'll talk about that later. Then I read some more to you. Then we got some speeches, and then we're going to dance. All of you going to dance. All right, sit right back. This message is for sisters, Arthi, Isa, Angelica, Jemima, Kira, Marissa, and Shiley. I would never have survived high school without my best friends. Thank you for never leaving me when I needed you all. I can honestly say meeting you guys was the best thing that ever happened to me. When we go to our separate lives, promise me, guys, you will never forget the heartfelt memories we shared. I promise I will do the same. And I promise, and promise me again, and every one of you guys, that we will never change. I love you, Kroot. You will never, you will forever be in my life. Sisters for life, Mara. Forgive me, this is tiny printing, but when I came back to GP for grade 11, I was introduced to two new teachers who I thought should deserve a special thanks towards tonight. They are the principals, Mr. Stickley and Mr. Holland. Mr. Stickley and Mr. Holland, I'd like to thank you for taking pride in your job and taking time to get to know the students, as well as making the school a clean place to be, as you spent many lunch times picking up garbage. What you guys do and you guys made my last 2 years worthwhile. Thank you so much. Jeez. Miss Huffer, you look nice today as always. Thanks for the great times. Philip. I'd like to thank Jacob Kearns, Dylan. I'd like to thank Dylan Tatomir, Jake Kearns. Sonny, learn to play defense from the boys. I would like to thank all the people who made this year a fun and memorable one. Love, Snail Thamavong. To all the grads, I hope you have a good night, and to those of you who were there for me through the hard times, thank you. And Miss Pruill, you rock. Love your little creeper. And you all look fantastic tonight. Thank you for giving me some amazing two short years at Guildford Park. We'll love and miss y'all, the American, also known as Lori. Oh. Sorry, a happy belated birthday to Sherwin and Bram. And before the video, just one last thing. Mr. Chambers, are you ready? And this is just wisdom beyond her years. Creme brulee was not a good idea. I'm lactose intolerant. A couple more notes from you guys. I'd just like to thank seven people in specific for getting me through the 5 years. A shout out to Dexter. To Derek. To Billy falling through, to Billy. To Marissa, to Matthew, to Mr. Sheehy, and to Miss Nielsen. Love you all. I owe you forever. I don't know.
Sign them. You want to know who they're from? What's your favorite
color? I read this somewhere yesterday. That's what it actually says. I read this somewhere yesterday. Going through high school together is like agreeing to team up during a zombie apocalypse. Eventually you go your separate ways, and if you happen to run into each other, you greet each other by saying, "Oh, glad you haven't been eaten by a zombie yet." And you continue on with your lives. Good luck and survive.
What?
I like that. Whatever happens in the future, you must all remember that Neville Chamberlain was a goof. God. God. It says God. I said goof. Sorry. No, he was a goof. For those of you who don't know, that was his great grand uncle. Dear Stickley. Stickley, are you listening? Okay. Thank you for giving me two spares when you weren't supposed to. And, wait, there's more. And for all the times I should have been expelled. You were there for me. Hashtag YOLOSWAG604. Yours truly, Bilal. Dear Grad 13, it's been a pleasure getting to know you all. We all may be going in different paths, but I know that these paths may cross in the future. I love you all. Joyce Tasian. P.S. We should have a 5-year reunion. Sorry, too soon. Too soon. I'd like to thank all my friends, teachers, and everyone who made GP a special place for me. Making it home together, we left our legacy on our school. From the TAF party? Can't read that. In the plaza, the plaza, grad barbecue, or the infamous compliments, we left our mark, grad 13, Will. Well, this one's succinct. Two words, Guildford Park. And a shout out to Cameron McKillop, who made GP unpredictable and hilarious. We miss you, Cameron. Maybe this is the best one possible to ever end with. Calculus 12 with Nielsen is better than any ride on the piano.
Now we don't really know how to use all these fancy forks and shiny spoons. And similarly, we don't really know how to write a speech either. I guess we should have paid more attention in English class.
No, it's okay. Sand class is all the way. That's right, Mr. Brandt. Sand rocks. Not English. Anyways, how are you guys enjoying your night so far?
Our memories at Guildford Park have been truly incredible, and we would need a good hour or so to babble on about. So instead, follow us on a much shorter journey as we take you down memory lane.
Please keep your hands and feet inside the vehicle at all times until the ride has come to a complete stop, and absolutely no horseplay. That means you, Nicola. Grade 8, what a horrible time. Now on to grade 9. Just kidding. I'm certain we all remember the intimidating transition from a small, closely-knit elementary school and only having one or two teachers into a huge high school with multiple teachers a day, along with 1,000 other kids.
We were thrown into the walls of Guildford Park with no recess or playgrounds, and in exchange, given a locker combination to memorize, and the challenge of getting up to class on time, a thing that some of us finally still had to accomplish. Our first real interaction with each other was a grade 8 retreat. It was an adventurous day filled with running, watermelon eating, team spirit, and fun activities. We were forced onto teams with people we didn't even know existed. When we got to school the next day, it was back to the regular, waiting for the older kid to finish out their locker, navigating through the overly crowded hallways, and avoiding changing in front of other kids in the PE chambers. Grading was about getting into the flow of everything, making new friends, yet keeping the old ones close by.
However, by the end of the year, things were different. It was no longer, hey, you're from MJS or Lena Shaw. Instead, we started making close friends with kids from other elementary schools. Grade 9 was a relaxing year. We got to miss school on Take Your Kid to Work Day. It was also the year we got our immunizations and everyone went around punching each other in the arms. However, it quickly came to an end.
Finally. Right smack in the middle was grade 10. It brought much excitement and stress to our lives. It was the year things were changing. Our first provincials, and we had 3 of them.
Some of us were even getting our first jobs, all thanks to planning class and the mock interviews. It was the year that we finally felt important as a teacher to finally recognizing us by our names in the halls. It was the year a lot of us stopped using our agendas because we lost them within the first 2 weeks of school. We were finally getting the hang of the whole high school experience, and we didn't even realize that grade 11 was quickly creeping up.
Seniors, it was the best word we could hear. Although we still weren't at the top of the food chain, we knew our high school journey was well on its way. The stress of knowing what we wanted to become was slowly emerging. Grade 11 was finally the year we weren't embarrassed to dress up on spirit days, whether it was the 60s day, pajama day, or cowboy day. We finally let loose and broke through our shells. It was also the few of us got our ends.
Finally, the year of our last. Joyce, be quiet, please. Finally, the year of our last. Our last dance, our last kid to put on the jerseys on our backs and shine in the courts, the fields, and the rings. And thankfully, our last year of provincials. But sadly, it was our last year together. Although it was bittersweet, grade 12 was a year where Guildford Park was not just our school, but it had become our beloved home away from home. It was a year where we truly bonded and forged friendships that would last a lifetime.
We had moments like our grad pranks, which brought smiles to not only our faces, but the faces of everyone else at the school as well. The fashion show and talent show, where there were late nights, hard work, sweat, determination. It was all through the perseverance that we learned how to balance projects on top of projects while still studying for other courses and not forgetting about our social lives. We will never forget the last minute cramming and how we all had a severe case of procrastination.
Get your grad transition in or I will not be selling you a ticket to grad, are the famous words of Ms. Nielsen. Just looking around this room, we are sitting amongst our future doctors, teachers, moms and dads, carpenters, lawyers, hairdressers, chefs, accountants, politicians, police officers, firemen, and any other possible job you can imagine, including McDonald's managers. Some of us will find ourselves in colleges or universities, getting jobs, traveling the world, and even though we will go our separate ways, the bonds we share will not break because we're just not friends, we're a family.
We made memories that we'll never forget. It was in school that we competed on sports teams, learned a new instrument, and gained life lessons that we will never forget. But most importantly, we made lifelong friends. So Guildford Park, class of 2013, always have hope and stay determined. If you can get through 5 years of struggles, drama, and pointless fights, you can do anything you set your mind to. Homework every night, well, for one reason, who bothered to do it and tests every week, is probably the one thing we won't miss. But tonight, forget all the homework. Forget all the tests because we did it. Let loose and enjoy what little time we have left with each other.
Congratulations, Grad Class of 2013. This is our last memorable night together, so let's enjoy it.
Raise your glasses and let's toast to one of the best nights of our lives. We love you all and hope to see you in time.
Get a good feeling, yeah.